Hi, I'm Dr. Peters with Peters Wellness Chiropractic and Massage. This week's quick video, I want to talk about Mother's Day. All right. Now, I'm talking about Mother's Day and thinking about it. Some of you may not even like your mothers. I don't know. But what I really want to think about with it is talking about gratitude, being grateful for people and situations in our lives that have really molded us and affected us in positive ways. And actually even being grateful for some of the negative crap that's happened to us in our lives that have helped us realize what we don't want in our lives. Because I think sometimes that's the most important thing. When I read these entrepreneurial books and they talk about, yes, learning from people and having mentors who have been successful and are where you want to be, but also learning from those who are where you don't want to be, and understanding the mistakes that people will make and make again and make again versus those who learn from their mistakes and make different and better choices to move forward and move onward and upward. And one of the things I come across a lot in different videos and books and education process for myself is talking about gratitude, being grateful for those things in our lives. And remember, you know, when they talk about people, someone might say to you, oh, you're so lucky. And you step back and you think, I'm lucky because I work my butt off and I work 14 hours a day, 5 or 6 days a week. And when an opportunity comes along, I'm ready to grab it because I know what a good opportunity is because I'm constantly working and struggling, being ready to take advantage of that opportunity. So being grateful to people in your life, but not only just being grateful and thinking about it and knowing that, but showing that gratitude, showing that love, showing that affection to those people around you. And sometimes I see it a lot in the practice where people will come in, you can just see their energy, man. They're just down. Some people, they don't like their job, but imagine starting a day being grateful for the job you have, being grateful for the opportunity to see that you're not really happy where you're at with your job, but what could you do at your job to double your income? You know, you're coming in, you're working 40 hours a week. What is the company looking for? What is it that you could do to train yourself to show that you are above average and you want to do more? And double your income. Or look at a situation and say, you know what, there's a need over here. I'm going to be the one to fill it. I'm going to fill that need, and then I'm going to go to the people above and I'm going to let them know, hey, there was this need. I filled it. And you want to let them know so that you're showing your value. So being grateful for everything that you have. Maybe you don't have very much, but you're grateful that you have what you do have. So with that gratitude, don't forget it's Mother's Day coming up and that you want to be grateful. And this week's handout put together a list of things that for Mother's Day, you know, just a quick list. Maybe getting your mother a gym membership, thinking health-wise, maybe nutritional supplements, workout attire, you know, if you have a mom who works out a lot, maybe a pet if you have a mom who's older and needs company, dark chocolate, you know, there's some health issues there. Now, some people might argue either way. The other thing, you know, music, things like that. Think of wonderful, positive, healthy gifts along with gratitude, love, and affection for those who have helped you. And hopefully your mother is one of those people. Have an awesome week and happy Mother's Day.